Hello, everyone, and as always, welcome back to Strategy Gaming Dojo, where we find, learn, and play one more turn of the great strategy games. And today it's into one of the very best of all time. It's Gary Grigsby's War in the East 2, and this is our Let's Play Against the Soviet AI. It is now February 14th, 1943. It's Valentine's Day on the Eastern Front. This episode is for lovers. Let's hope old Saint Valentine helps us out this time around. I am going to actually start all the way down in the Crimea. I find in the south, what happens the further south you go really affects how much we can potentially move up north. And we've obviously got the same situation we had last winter, where the AI is pushing towards Brest-Litovsk, Warsaw, pinching at Minsk here. And I need to move more forces up here eventually, right? I mean, we want the Soviets to get out here a little ways, and then we'll try to cut them on the spring. We've got to dig our way out of a 2.5 million man hole. That didn't sound right. But anyway, you know what I mean? We've got to catch up with manpower, and one way to do that is a huge encirclement in the center. That's what we did last winter. Served us very well. Hopefully, we can do it this time. But as you can see, he's bearing down on the Carpathian Mountains as well, and Romania. We're also going to lose our Italian troops soon. So all things to keep in mind, but let's get down into the Crimea and get after it. Oh, by the way, sorry, I'm not live streaming today. I don't know. I've had a weird internet all day. It's taken me forever to upload a couple of videos, and I thought, man, there is nothing that pisses me off more than when we start live streaming and it craps out on us. It drives me nuts. And I thought, well, rather than get on there, I wouldn't be myself because I'd be continually worried that the internet, we're going to have a skip, as we used to sometimes. Rather than that, I just decided, well, let's record one. We'll all get together tomorrow. That'll be February 10th of the year of our Lord 2022. And we'll turn the turn. So let's get moving so we can get to that point, certainly. Okay, we'll go right over to the Kerch. And one thing you'll notice is these guys have really built up. I mean, look at this. We had them on refit. I'm going to take that actually off now and put them on ready because, I mean, they've rebuilt. And these are some of the best units we have over here now. I think maybe first guards. I may actually throw this on the rail and have that be one of the units that comes over here. And we'll just leave 20,000 men back here. The AI show no inclination to get over here to the Kerch. Where could he get off the train? Well, it'll have to have 100 left so he can get off the train there this time. If I just move him, you can get the same distance, right? Well, rather than clog up the train lines, does it really matter? How much freight are we getting on the train lines? I don't know. But we went from Sevastopol all the way out here last time. So I'm going to move this around and some of our, less desirable units, I guess. We may move off the line. So let's move this stuff. First guard? Nope, that's not the one I moved. You big dummy. There's the first guards. All right, let's settle in. Let's go now. I need your best today. Let's click off that. Okay, so he's up and along the way here. He's still connected to second. But we could put him in 11th. Speaking of 11th, this is under the finely haired Radu Cornet. That's what I'm going to call him. It's maybe Corn, but I'm going to say it's Cornet. And of course, Radu, that doesn't get more Romanian than that. Okay, can he get any support units? Not out here, he can't. There's just no way to get him over here. Really. Oh, I want to click the Romanians. One of the reasons they got food this time is I clicked them up to a 3. I'm going to actually put their supply priority down to a 2. Is that true? Well, you know what? Let's turn it back to a 3 very quickly, and we'll look here in a moment and see if that makes sense. Now, these two secondary rail construction got out here. I think they've rebuilt the rail completely. Out here, yeah, they have in the Crimea. They've rebuilt all of this. So, very nice. I think that one will have to finish this turn. But they've rebuilt all that. Fourth Romanian is in charge of all of this. Let's get off the rail. Why is it showing We put these guys back to him. Got it. These guys are not in great shape, certainly. They're all unready. I think all three of these, I may try to get out of here and put this unit here or put it here. I mean, we're going to have to replace the Italians soon. Now, these Italians don't appear to withdraw, or at least I don't see that they do. This one does. This is the only one that does. Okay, good to know. This Italian unit, we can bring this Italian over, maybe bring him up here, keep one of these and send two off. We can't get rid of the two rails. This is the unit that I brought across the strait last time, and I'm gonna put him right. Ooh, boy, he could go over here too and take their place. That's tempting. And then to set them back somewhere. How far to? Oh, wow, they can go all the way to Sevastopol. Interesting. Well, I don't want them to get all that freight, but I may put them in here and move him out there. That's possible. First Romanian, it's showing as ready. This is showing as unready. The Ita or I'm sorry, the German unit, the 292nd, actually got some food. It's ready now. I mean, it's only got 6,000 men, but it's ready. All right. So this Romanian unit, I'm going back and forth. I think this one's stronger. I want to bring that over here, especially if that one unit's leaving. Okay, so let's do this. Let's take the two weakest over here. Unready, set static. Let's put one on top of the depot there. And let's put another one right there. And I mean, it's possible we rebuild here. I'm gonna put them on refit. It's possible we rebuild or we ship them across. We may ship them across. All right, let's put him up there. All right, now this, he can go into 11th. Yeah, let's put him. Make sure I've got this right. He's got these three units in 11th. He's got fourth and seventh here. Who else are you commanding, champ? I don't see the other two. He's got all of these except for the German. Weird. Okay. Yeah, it's saying he's got six of nine. All right. Well, oh, fine. 11th Romanian, he's now got 8 of 9. And he's gonna have 10 of 9 here in a moment. 11th Romanian. Okay, yeah, he's got 10 of 9. Fine. He doesn't have any support units though, which is real killer. The Italians, and I mean that not necessarily as a pun. Alpini, okay. He's got 8 of 9. One of his guys is going to leave, though. This mountain Romanian, 8 of 9. Okay. Do I have another Romanian corps? I think I got rid of most of them out here anyway. So this all looks fine. This unit will have to go into his command, I guess. Mountain Romanian. All right. Well, we'll do it. Mountain Romanian corps. So they're both just one over. Does he have any support units? No. And we can't get any over here. So they're running without support. This German unit looks pretty good. He finally got some food there, and that brought, bumped him up quite a bit. If we look, his defensiveness now 23. If we Z it, you see the 23. We've got 14 there, 4, 10, 1, but 16, 6. Okay. I mean, it's not great. It's going to have to be good enough. Some of this we may get out next time, or if these guys rebuild, we'll get something else out, or we'll replace that Italian unit. But I think that's it for the Crimea. I don't think there's too much else we could do. Costanta continues to supply the Crimea and do it quite well, moving this rail unit down here to draw freight. And now we're getting, a decent amount over here. And we've gotten a lot off of the Crimea as well. So that has helped. Back here, we got Romanian High Command, Romanian Air. We've got the 4th Romanian Corps. I mean, it may be worth it to send one over eventually, but this guy has got like no men. Or, yeah, he's got like 4,500. Usually these corps headquarters have a heck of a lot more than that. Third Romanian Army, Fifth Romanian Corps, all of these guys really could go back to the reserves, but I don't want to take them all there. I want to use some of them as rebuilders. And so let's move this guy up here. Sure. And let's move fourth. I want to have a nice selection of places where I can go back and rebuild units if possible. Let's put him there. I've already got one such thing there. And then we have a whole third Romanian army. I guess I'll set him with, whoops. I guess I'll set him with the other guy. There we go. And put him right there. So, okay, this did rebuild under 7th Romanian Corps. So we had it sitting here with the headquarters. We had it on refit, and it did rebuild. And I'm going to try to rebuild as many of these Romanian units as I can because, frankly, we need them. We've just got, places where we certainly need them. 318th, let's get you off the ship, and then we'll march you over here in a second. We'll send that off to the reserves. We can put the whole ID together finally in the reserves. Imagine that. Wow. Hey, oh, I thought we had Hungarians. Unfortunately, I had that on defensiveness and not movement points. I almost got excited that there were more Hungarians to bring to the fore, but no such luck. All right, let's take that off. How are they doing in town? Well, we flew a bunch of freight out here, so they're actually doing quite well. He did, when I say he, I mean 7th Flieger, did get some units last time, or some men, I should say. It rebuilt a little bit. Still not great, but he's showing a 59 defense in Odessa. Obviously, Odessa, very difficult to deal with as a town. We could attach, got the airbase. We could assign AA construction units. We could take that potentially almost up to a level 4 port. We've got, or fort. We've got this as a priority one out here. Is that good? That's fine. We're flying some freight in there, so that's fine. 34th Corps under Grossner. He's got all of the support units he needs. Supply priority two. Oh, that reminds me. You know what? Let's go ahead and keep these guys at three. I don't love it, but by the same token, it seemed to work. And I put the Germans on a four, so they're even getting more. And I've got the Italians on a three. Yeah, I've got Kempf on a four. That works. That works. So he goes back to Kempf. This goes back to the army. He goes back to the army. And the Italian goes back to the army. Okay, that all works. And then these guys actually should be attached. They're in 4th Romanian right now. Yeah, that's fine. So they're attached to this guy. You know what? I'm going to attach him directly to Kempf. That probably works better. So you're in the German army now. Okay. Put them directly under Kempf. That makes more sense. Okay, cool. That will help them rebuild too, because the Germans are on four and Kempf is on a four for supply priority out here. So those might rebuild very nicely. Put them right up here. Maybe we can just move the Italians out of here altogether. That could be something we look into. We got a 10 of 9 situation up here. I think we're going to have to deal with that. Sixth Army is going back to Army Group South. He's got 24 of 27, so he's, underneath. Antonescu is sitting here. Is this where we have our depot? It is. I just hate that. I want him. Actually, I'm going to put him right here. I don't think it makes any difference whatsoever, other than, well, did it throw him out of command? No, 22 of 45, that's plenty. I just can't see him underneath there. That's the whole reason I moved him. So I'm just going to move him down here right on the coast. He gets a nice coastal view of the Gulf of Odessa. That's why he's paid the big bucks. We've got our motorized here that withdraws on turn 90. So we've got just a few more turns. Speaking of headquarters, you know what? Let's look at the infantry first, and I think I'm going to move these around a little bit. Even though the motorized is next, I'm going to look at the infantry. I hate having him right here, but I think what I'm going to do is actually stack him, move him not there. How about there? I want to be able to see all of this a little better. Now he's got these two groups here, but why not give him this group and move this guy around? And then he can take the other. That makes more sense to me. And so this is directly back into 34th. Okay, 34th is under Martinick. Martinick's pretty decent. He's got his support units, so let's just make sure it's actually 44th. 44th. All right, so let's put all of these guys in 44th. They're actually quite beaten down. Not looking great. So we'll put that in 44th. Let's put this in 44th. Okay, and let's put the next one in 44th. And now he's got all of his guys right in front of him. 44th Corps. Okay, so they're all in 44th. That now bumps Martinick up to 14 and 9. Well, that's not what we want. Let's actually just set him. Nah, I'm not going to set him with the Slovaks. Let's move him around. I say him. 4th Corps under Hasse, 8 and a 7. You want as much in with Hasse as you can get. Let's put him on this rail line. And yeah, these guys are both then going to go into 4th Corps. I don't like to switch them this much. They do take a slight penalty when they switch headquarters, but I want to get this all ironed out while we have the chance here. All right, so now those two are in 4th. He should also be in 4th. Okay. 4th Corps. Excellent. All right, so now Hasse's got 6. Martinick's down to 8 of 9. And we've got 10 of 9 over here. But I don't want mismatch cores at all. All right, now let's look at the motorized under Reinhardt. He's got 10 of 9. Does he need to have 10 of 9? Well, he's got this motorized. Well, let's do this again. He's got the Hungarian armor. He's got this motorized. That's what's putting him over, is the Hungarian armor. And the Czech. He's got the Czech group as well. All right, well, he's 10 of 9. Let's make sure. Yeah, he's got the support units he needs and wants. What's back above us now? Not a whole lot. Let's also make sure these guys are locked. Locked. Okay. Reinhardt, locked. Good. 44th Martinick is locked. He's got his support units. Okay. I think that all looks fine. I'm going to keep this guy in reserve. We're going to have to figure out something to put over here, but we don't have. I mean, if we look at the Z ratings here, well, that's not bad. I mean, we build up these fort levels, right? X, 32. This is a 6. That's not great. Okay. No, not great. One of these guys, really, I need to stack with this. I mean, that's very vulnerable, that motorized. This motorized is doing okay. 60th, he's doing just fine. There. All right, Martinick. Then we come around. We got Hasse. He's got his guys here. And there's a motorized division that's sitting here that is part of 14th. Now, that's got 8 of 9. It's under Walter Nering. Cannon, mixed, Pioneer, Werfer. Wouldn't mind if he got something else. Not looking good. Oh, also, you can go in and put on refit the support units that are mangled. I haven't seen an opportunity to do that yet, but you can do it, certainly. Okay, so we're gonna get mismatch penalty there. I wonder, well, that's just not strong enough. Although I could double stack there and move the Hungarian armor here. Now he's a 28 by himself. That would take him to a 34. This is a 16. We've got a 12, a 10, and an 11. Ugh. Yuck. Well, I think we need to do that, and then we get away from any mismatch penalties at all. So that's a 12, 10, 11, 12. Put him there, and then if we look at him total now that's a 21. I could put the check right on top of him, right? This, did I say check? I meant Slovak. I'm sure that's a major faux pas. But now we have no mismatched cords there. I like that much better. Okay, this motorized is fine. We do have a mismatch here, but we have this Panzer Division in reserve. He's sitting back there waiting for Nering to give him the order. Let's go. Now, what is this infantry? That's the terrible infantry. We've got a 14 and a 13. Here we've got a 15 and a 21 with the Panzer Division. Ew, that Panzer Division doesn't look great either, quite frankly. I'd like to send him back to the reserves at some point if we could, but no such luck now. I think we got to keep this all the same. Now, what do we have back here? We had a Mountain Division. That needs to be on refit. I thought it was 55th Corps. Flipped over, I guess, because I'm pretty sure that was on refit. Romanians. Where do we want to put these gosh darn Romanians? Well, it's a good question. We've got Viking that got blitzed last time, down to 6,400 men there. Wow, he got hurt. I think we need to move this up and we'll make our rebuilders there. But let's put the Romanians on the line. I don't love it. I certainly don't love it. This is quite weak. It shows as a 23 together, but you know, we've got an 82. That's mainly because of the damn fort level. This really looks weak right there. Now, because they moved, they got a little tired. That went down. Okay, sure. We got 8 of 9. Let's look at the Panzer Corps. That always makes me happy. Fredder Pico got a bunch of sevens there. Bicycle infantry. Oh, right. Fredder Pico needs some stuff. He doesn't have good support units. Still doesn't really have an opportunity to get him either. What's in 55th Corps? It's no, I unlocked that. That's good. 7th Romanian. What can he choose from? Not a whole lot. All right. Well, shoot fire. This guy, that's fine where he is. Trying to decide whether to put the Romanians right there, have them start digging in. I need him. I need him. Let's put him up there. All right. He's only a 3 when he gets up here, but I could stack him with Viking. Like that. Now they don't look that strong right now, but they'll start to dig in. That's a strong unit. And I've got the Panzer Division right behind them in reserve. So hopefully, that'll do something. Now I need that Romanian 7th up here, though. Right. Let's put him on the road up here. So that's in command. That doesn't look promising. I mean, I could stack there. What's his construction value? Would he dig in pretty? Yeah, it's really nice. He would dig these guys in really fast. I'm going to put him on ready and I'm going to move him on the line for a turn. Now you can see the defense looks better, but it'll get even better as we go on here. I mean, they're a little tired from the march. 5th Mountain. Okay, I've got it on refit and I've got that rebuilding. So we've got our little rebuilding zones back here with the Romanians at least. Then I've got the Romanian cavalry that's just sitting here. That's fine. I mean, I don't have a problem with that. He's tried to break through here. Oh, I think what it will do though is let's put this Romanian cavalry. Oh. He took that depot. Well, that's weird. Okay, not weird actually, but he put a support unit in there and we just took it back. Okay, thanks. Rightio then. We've got this infantry division. Now, 3rd Romanian is here. So I've already put some Romanians on the line. I had no choice, but we need to blow this out of here because we're getting a little surrounded. We've also got the Arab special there. All right, so let's take this infantry. Ugh. Let's see what we can get done with just infantry. When we go up here, let's take the Panzers out and let's see what that shows us as combat values. Yeah, he's stronger than we are. Boy, these Panzer divisions are not in good shape. I mean, we've got to attack with everything. We got to attack with everything. Let's go. Let's try to blow him out of here. Do we do it? He does. He goes flying. Now, we lose 15 tanks. Wow. We lost 1,000 men. He lost 2,000. 52 and 61. We lost 15. We got to knock him back. We have no choice. We're sitting here in level 3 forts. I'm not backing up anymore. We've got the Arab special here. Now, what's the deal with these guys? How are they doing? Not great. 47, 31. Make sure we've got the support units here. Von Vettengoff does have his support units. Romanian, can they get anything from here? Nope. Oh, wait a minute. There we go. He can get a bunch of stuff from Romanian High Command. I assume 7th can as well. Excellent. Okay, cool. So let's pull down all. Now, see, he can't. Why is that? Hold on. I have to switch his command. Because 6 certainly can. Right? Didn't I just, let's go look again. No, it says I can't there. Let's attach them. What does Romanian High Command have? Yeah, that's what I thought. He's got a lot of support units just sitting here. Well, is Army Group Antonescu not running to him? No, it is. We should be able to pick from that. Look at all these frickin' Romanian machine gun battalions. I get why we wouldn't be able to that way. Can this guy pick from him? He goes directly back. Are they locked? Are those support units locked or something? What the hell? Come on now. Third Romanian. Can I pick? No. But this corps goes directly back to Romanian High Command. Well, I may have to go through here and assign them one by one. Boy, that sounds exciting. This is 7th Romanian Corps. This is 6th Romanian Corps. We need these support units. So I'll give half to 7th and half to 6th. Maybe not quite that many. Let's put you down. Can they go down? Kempf? Wow, this is weird. 4th Panzer. It wants to go down into the German army. Because he's attached to OKH, maybe. Is that why? I think they want that under German command, maybe. Why would I not be able to... This is anti-tank. This is a bunch of good stuff back here. Yeah, now we can start putting these guys into this, like this anti-tank company. Okay. Good to know. What about the machine gun battalions? They've got a really good defensive value. 1st Romanian Army, 3rd Romanian Army, 4th Romanian Army, and Antonescu. Okay. Well, let's look at these guys again. He's going to 3rd Romanian Army. There's 3rd Romanian. There's 6th Romanian goes back to Antonescu. We could put him in 3rd Romanian as well. He's only got that one unit. 7th does. That guy there. 6th obviously has a lot more here. And then what's this? This is 4th, right? 4th Romanian Army? Interesting. Okay, well, I'm going to put this guy back into 3rd Romanian Army. And let's see if we can get those support units if we do that. So let's put him directly back to 3rd Romanian. All right, now 3rd Romanian's got a little bit more. And then 7th is already in 3rd Romanian. Okay, let's go out here. Let's go to this core. Assign support units. Yeah, I can't go grab them. So I'm going to have to push them directly down. That's going to be exciting. Tell you what, I'll do that offline. Basically, what I'm going to end up doing, I'll just do one of them, is go in here to Now, it looked like the artillery, we couldn't really do it. Third Romanian Army. Where is it? Now, this wants to go to the Germans. I know why. I know why. That's a German unit. That's a German support unit. Sorry if you were screaming at the screen. That's because it was in a Romanian headquarters. Let's see if we can do it this way down to. Yeah, okay. There we go. So let's put this down into 3rd Romanian Army and 3rd Romanian Army. So that was a German unit right on the top, and that's why I got a little confused by that. Sorry, third. Looks like we can assign some out to the Crimea. So let's do that. Fourth, third. Now, I don't know why we can't pull them down right now. That seems a little odd to me. Third, fourth, Antonescu. I mean, they really should be running. Third Romanian should run through Antonescu. But I'll go back and check that later. All right, I'm not going to do all of these. But like these machine gun battalions, those are huge. I mean, look at the defense, 6 points. We should start attaching them directly to units too, if we can, eventually. But right now, it looks like we can just push them to the armies. Okay, let's keep moving. I'll do that later. Hey, it's a learning experience sometimes. First Romanian ID. Well, let's see. Actually, see. Can we pull anything? No. Okay. He's back to 6th Romanian Corps, which is now going back to 3rd Romanian Army. Whew, my goodness. This motorized is not in the best shape. I'd like to hit on that tank corps, and I'm not saying at the bar. But I don't think we can do it. We just don't have enough strength. I only did this because he had busted through, but now we'll put that cavalry in there. Hopefully hold off against that from now on. Or at least for a turn or two. Nothing to do there. This Romanian ID is quite strong. I mean, if he builds up in the rough, that'll be tough to take. That's a big if. Rightio then. We've got first Panzer over here. He's got one group there. Oh, speaking of which, fourth Panzer, he's 28 of 27. First Panzer is 32 of 27, so way over the cap. But we just don't have any other armies. Eventually we're going to have to turn somebody into an assault army. It may be 2nd Panzer Army and just dump more in there. This unit, brand new, 321st. We've got the cavalry sitting back here in this little city. That looks fine. We've got infantry Panzer there, and we've got Netherlands motorized behind them. I'm just going to let as many of these sit as I can and let them build up combat prep points. Also build up fort levels to the extent they're not all the way maxed, and just leave them. I mean, I don't think there's anything else to do. I'd like to be in these other hexes, but you move it out here, it's immediately going to get routed. We've got Army Group South down here, just kind of in a very weird place. No offense to anybody that lives in Campulung, but never heard of that one. He's kind of up in the mountains. He's up in his Erie, or Airy, if you prefer. Of 56. Okay, we've got the two cavalry sitting back here behind. We've got a level two of fort here, 11,000 men. It's not horrible, not great. Got a panzer here, got a really weak unit there. Don't like that. That looks vulnerable. Now he's got 12,000 men. What do we have in town? Oh God, only 14,000. That doesn't look good. Almost tempted to double stack there and let this panzer just sit here. Is this in the, no, it's in the light woods. Ay, that's not great. We've got Army Group A, 1st Corps, 30th Corps up here. We should spread these corps out and be rebuilders if we need them. Let's take 30th Corps. I'll put him down here. Is that right? Is that what I wanted to do? What was 1st Corps? He goes to 4th Army. Wow, we're a little ways away from 4th Army, buddy. We may put him on a train, but if to the extent we need to rebuild something, we can put it back here on the depot. I assume I have a depot at Stanislav. We do. Boy, I don't want to Swiss cheese this line anymore. He hasn't built at all. I guess what, you know what I'll do is I'll back him on here. Okay, now we're still every other hex, which at least gives you a little zone of control cover. He's a decent unit. These guys really aren't, but I don't think we have any other choice. Let's take their headquarters and move it right back here. He's, you know, storing plenty of freight here. We've got plenty. So we move it there. It's 8 of 9. Let's just back up in case I didn't check this out. Kreising, he's got all the support units he needs. We've got 13th Corps. This is Zorn. He's got everything he needs. Cavalry Romanian. Well, hell, hopefully he can get some support units. I still don't know why I can't pull those down to the extent they're Romanian. I got confused about that German one right up top. Of course, you can't pull that out to Romanian corps in this sense, but or push them down. But as a matter of fact, before I forget, which is extremely possible, why don't we take that German mixed artillery? And let's put that up to OKH. Okay, so now we pop him up there, and that works. All right, we're still on defensiveness here. 15, well, maybe I want it on defensiveness. 71, 14, 39, 16. That's very weak given where he is, but we got a Panzer division there. Maybe that'll be all right. 53, 55, 43. Hey, the Romanians are showing up right there on the defensive value. I like it. 44. We've got at least a little bit. You know, generally when I play defense, like the first game, when I play the Soviets, you know, I like to have a layered defense because think about how much movement, even if you blow all this out, how many movement points that's going to take. This is not layered, but I don't think we have a few things in reserve. At least it looks a little better than it did a few turns ago. That's always my goal. this is just an 11 out here. Hey, ooh, hey, okay. That's Golnick. Let's make sure he's got everything he needs. Golnick does have a good amount of support units. That all looks fine. This headquarters can move on top of that depot. Although, that's 11th Corps. He's 8 of 9. I may want some of that this to be in that corps. We've got 17th Army all the way up here. We got a little bit of freight up here, but we didn't push it out from here. We pushed it out from there. 17th Army probably. Well, he's awfully far north, I feel like, but that's okay, I guess. This headquarters I just moved down, but I think I might move him up, and I may move this one up, and then move this one up? Maybe. 8 of 9. No, that's not what I meant. 4 of 9 here, but let's give these other two units to him. So this is 54th Corps. I've seen better. Do we have any Stugs? No. Got a flak regiment. What does he need? He's got three. Okay, he's got three artillery, Panzerjäger. I guess that's not terrible. He's got two Panzerjägers. Well, if we get any tanks up here in the swamp, this guy's golden. Let's turn the eight off. There we go. All right, so this is 54th Corps. Let's put these guys in 54th Corps. One. And then this unit, two. All right, 54th Corps. He's got 12,000. That's a brand new unit. He's got 12,000. I'm going to put him up here, I think. That's a clear hex. Gosh darn it. Wish it wasn't. I certainly wish it wasn't. I want these guys in the swamp. Well, at least he's already built. Oh, I do have a German unit there. I didn't notice that. In the first instance, okay, let's get 11th Corps around here. All right, let's bring that up here. He's got all of his guys, that's fine. Okay, so we do have a German. Gosh darn it, that's awesome. Okay, so this division with 12,000, he can move into that fort level. What is this? Light woods. Gosh darn it. That's Robno. I want to keep Robno. I mean, not that it's, some huge deal that we keep Robno. Tell you what, why don't we do this? How far can you go? You can get up to the swamp. Perfect. Why don't we do this? I'm going to attack right here, but I don't want the Hungarians in. Let's do the two German infantry. See if we can get him moved back. Nope, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Well, okay. That didn't go quite as planned. Now then, let's move this German unit up here. And we're going to put him in 11th Corps. Well, I'll be damned. I just put him in 54th. Okay. He's only got one division now. No, he's got two, 4 of 9, and we'll put this in next time. He's still in command. That's fine. I don't like that. I tried to hit that just because if we could have knocked that back, but now we've got a big trouble in Little China here. Luckily, we've got 21,000 troops there, and we've got this unit. We may have to bring another unit in here. 17th Army, we're sitting here at Lutsk. What is this? Koval? Okay. Trying to extend a little north. Oh, we've got this headquarters up here too. 52nd Corps. This is under Bouger. Are you Bougie? Maybe. Let's see. I think he can go in right here. I think he's gonna have to go in right there. That's again in the swamp, so I like that. We'll move the Hungarian group back, and I think we'll give Bouger. Oh, well, he's got this all the way up here. Okay, so this guy's got 4 of 9. He can take these two as well. And then he can't take this one this turn, but next turn. But he can take this one. So this will go into 11th Corps. Okay. 11th Corps. And we'll move 11th Corps actually a little bit north here. Let's move him on that road for now. He goes all the way back. Yeah, he's still 5 of 5. We'll put that in 11th Corps next time so these corps will match. I think that's a brand new unit. So I'm going to take this Hungarian group and try to push him up here. What is this? Lightwoods? Boo. Let's put this on movement points. My Alexa's freaking out. It's driving me crazy. What's going on over there? Lightwoods. Well, okay. We'll move this up here. This is getting a little jagged, I'll give you that. What is this up here? Lightwoods, Lightwoods. I really wanted to end up in the swamp up here, but that doesn't seem to be happening. Gosh darn it. Where else can I get into swamp here? It's not a question you usually ask yourself. Oh, 52nd Corps, right. He right now has only this unit. So I've got, oh, I've got a brand new German division up there. Sometimes I forget, next turn I'm like, oh, what? What is this? This is swamp, right? Cool. He could come forward. That's Lightwoods. He could come forward one, two. Lightwoods. Yeah, let's put this guy in the swamp. He doesn't need to be that advanced. Let's put him in the swamp. And then this German unit can then move up to here. Okay, this is starting to take a little bit of shape at least. Germans, Germans, Germans. And then we can start putting these guys in the swamp a little bit. I wanted to do it right there, but I don't think I can. This first Hungarian can go there. The routed unit I'll bring back to the depot. Yeah, let's stack it at the depot. So I've got two stacked there. Let's put them with the headquarters. They're both on refit. Fine. But we're going to have to get something up there to protect all of that mess. Here's another rebuilder. Oh, nice. 10th Hungarian has rebuilt. Like that. Let's put him in the swamp. That's the hex I've been trying to get into for turn after turn. Now, this light unit can't get there, but he can get to the swamp here for now. Boy, those Italians, that doesn't look particularly promising. And hopefully, if some of this will frickin' rebuild, let's see, one, two, three, four, five. He's got these guys. Well, we definitely got to back him up. Gosh darn it, that's not what I meant to do. Yeah, back him up. Back your thing up. Well, I see why I had him there. We got to keep him right there. But we go German, German, German every other one anyway, and that's a brand new Hungarian unit. Now, I need these guys to rebuild. I don't think that can hold anything off. Do I have anything else down here? Just Second Hungarian Army. Okay. Yeah, this, well, at least we have a German unit out here. He is in the swamp. He's just drawing that. We may have to take one more of these out of Warsaw and try to protect this area. But I'm actually feeling much better about this area than I was when the turn started. This, hey, it's hanging on by a thread. We got our fingernails, and the guy's standing over us with a big boot, about to step on our hand and let us, have us let go. But we're hanging on. This was Mission Impossible out here. As we keep moving up, I'll look at these Italians. We may move a couple. I say a couple. We can definitely move this one Italian unit out here, but it withdraws very soon. So by train, I can bring him out here and take him off the train. That would allow me to move the German unit. How far can I take the German unit? Why does he? Oh, I guess I did that this turn. I did? Okay, sure. I guess I, we were almost down here, but I want to go back and redo some of this. There's stuff we still need to do. But that's all for tomorrow when we live stream. Yeah, we'll finish this up. We'll turn the turn. I'm going to try to do it every three episodes now, and I'm going to try to do at least six episodes a week. So we turn two turns, and we can motor through this. Whether it's live streamed now tomorrow, February 10th, I will be live streaming at 3 o'clock. And we'll see. If I can't live stream one day, something happens or whatever, I will try to put up a video. All right, so that we keep moving. In the south, again, we didn't move a whole lot. We changed a few of the commands, but like through here, I think we tried one attack, didn't go particularly well right there. But other than that, we really didn't move a whole lot. I mean, we are in pure defensive mode, as we really should be at this point. I may stack him with a German. Or I may put him up here. I think it makes sense to have him right there. What have you got? Yeah, let's put him there. We've got double Germans. Let's stack him with the good German division, just so I have both of those in command. And let's give him. Oh, hell, I don't know. Hungarian artillery? Sure. Anyway. Thank you so much for joining me. We'll pick this up tomorrow and finish up the turn. See what happens. See if we can survive. I'll go as long as it takes to get the turn. So anyway, thank you guys so much. Talk to you tomorrow. Have a great one. Strategy Gaming Dojo.